There is still so much in the world worth fighting for. So much that is beautiful, so many wonderful people working to reverse the harm, to help alleviate the suffering, and so many young people dedicated to making this a better world. All conspiring to inspire us and to give us hope that it is not too late to turn things around if we all do our part. Jane Goodall. In 1960, a time when people believed that only humans had minds and all other animals were incapable of thinking, Jane Goodall discovered in Gombe, Tanzania, that chimpanzees are our closest relatives in the animal kingdom. She found out that chimpanzees have complex social systems, natural drives, and they use and make tools. They wouldn't be able to do that if they didn't have minds to think. Her discoveries broke the human-animal barrier, challenging researchers to consider the ethics of animal research and inspiring and educating others about our ecological responsibilities to the environment and the creatures living inside it. Jane Goodall was born in England in 1934. Her mother, a successful novelist, and her father, an engineer, provided a comfortable life. When Jane was a toddler, her mother gave her a stuffed animal chimpanzee, which to this day, Jane still has. Jane had been interested in animals since day one. She did well in school, but she always wanted to be outside and with animals. She would study all kinds of animals. For example, one time she spent 5 hours in a hen house trying to figure out how they lay their eggs. Jane's love for animals grew stronger and stronger, and by the time she was 10, her dream was to live with animals in Africa. Now, most parents would have just laughed and let their kids dream on, but Jane's mother encouraged her big dream and even helped it become a reality in her future. Jane's journey really started taking place when she was 18. She had finished secondary school and was now working 3 jobs, a secretary, a waitress, and assistant editor in a film studio. Jane hadn't taken her eye off the ball. She was working so much to save up for a trip to Africa. All that hard work eventually paid off because in 1957, when she was 23 years old, she finally traveled to Africa. She sailed to Mombasa on the East African coast. She went to visit a childhood friend in Kenya. And soon after, she was introduced to the famous anthropologist, Louis Leakey. Leakey would come to be her mentor. He was the curator of the Curadon Museum in Nairobi. The oldest known human remains of the time were discovered by him and his wife. He was famous for it because it supported his theory that the origins of humans came from Africa, not Asia or Europe, like so many believed. Soon after their introduction, Leakey hired Jane, first as his secretary and then to participate in anthropological digs. This led Jane to go to some islands on Lake Victoria to study vervet monkeys. Leakey believed and hoped that some long-term studies on chimpanzees, gorillas, and or orangutans, which are some of the primate species that human beings are most closely related to, would give major evolutionary information about our human animals' ancestors' behavior. There had been very few other successful studies on chimpanzees for multiple reasons. The notable women scientist biography of Jane Goodall said that few studies of chimpanzees had been successful. Either the size of the safari frightened the chimps, producing unnatural behaviors, or the observers spent too little time in the field to gain comprehensive knowledge. Leakey chose to ask Jane to do this study because he believed that as a woman, Jane would have a more patient and careful mindset and temperament to sustain isolation in the wild for that long of a period of time. Now, since Jane had no formal scientific education and lacked even a general college degree, many experts objected to the choice that Leakey had made, but he insisted that it was better that she had little formal training because then Jane had a higher chance of describing what she saw and not being biased about what she thought she should have been reporting through previous education or expectations that she would have been taught. In 1960, at the age of 26, Jane set off to Gombe National Park in Tanzania in southeastern Africa to set up camp with only an African cook and her mother to accompany her. Even though Jane hadn't brought any formal training with her, she had something more important, something that wouldn't let her quit or lose patience in her research. She had her never-ending passion and love for animals, as well as her determination and craving for adventure. As Jane walked into this project, she thought that she would be there for around 3 years. Little did she know that she would be there for over 2 decades. The chimpanzees lived in the forest surrounding the shore, so her settlement was very close to her research. For the first few days, Jane worked on her own or with some of the native guides. Her very first attempt to study the chimps failed. She got too close too quickly and they fled from sight. Even though unsuccessful, her determination kept her going, and she moved to find a new group of chimps to observe. Once with a new suitable group, she made a soon-to-be groundbreaking and non-threatening observation pattern. Every morning at the same time, she would appear on high ground near a feeding area along the Cocombe Stream Valley. Jane would follow them through the forest, gradually moving closer and closer. Within a year, she had come within 30 feet of their feeding area, and within 2 years of seeing her every day, they feared her no more and even approached her in search of bananas. Jane Goodall achieved things that many other scientists hadn't even gotten close to in studying chimpanzees. For one, she was able to build such strong bonds with more than half of the reserve's 100 chimps that they trusted her and even sat right next to her. In other studies, chimpanzee researchers had given the chimps numbers instead of names, and they ignored their differences in personalities, intelligence, and social systems. Jane was able to break through the barriers between chimps and humans because everyone thought that chimpanzees were these violent, aggressive animals with crude social arrangements, but she was patient and discovered that they were so much more than that. Jane had founded a systematic way to link humans and animals. Jane Goodall had studied at Cambridge's University between 1962 to 1965, after Louis Leakey had arranged for her to work on a doctorate degree. There she was able to put more scientific weight to her discoveries. Jane graduated with a PhD in ethology and became one of only 8 people from Cambridge's long history to ever graduate without having received an undergraduate degree. Her first major text, In the Shadow of Man, came out in 1971. Jane had become an activist. She was advocating for animals in captivity. She turned her attention to captive chimpanzees, research animals in laboratories all over the world used to study human diseases. Since they were so much like humans, given her expertise, she was able to use her knowledge and fame to limit the amounts of animals being experimented on and to convince researchers to improve the poor conditions under which the animals lived. Jane also worked on improving the conditions for animals at zoos and for the conservation of chimpanzees' habitats. The Jane Goodall Institute was founded in 1977, a global conservation organization that helps more than 130 communities improving, inspiring, and protecting the lives of people, animals, and the environment. They have since helped to protect close to 1.5 million acres and more than 5,000 chimpanzees and gorillas' habitats. One of the Institute's larger programs is the Roots and Shoots program, which involves almost 5,000 young people in nearly 100 countries and teaches them to address problems in their community and to be good citizens to the earth. Jane had captured the attention of the world with her scientific approach, personal documentaries, numerous television programs, and media coverage, and she was now ready to advocate for the habitats and environment. Jane Goodall went on to win multiple awards and honors. Jane's work has reached out from top-class scientists to little children who are interested in animals. She has inspired so many. Jane devoted her life to the study of primates, their intricate personalities, their communities, their advanced ways, their environment. She became an expert award-winning barrier breaker, leading the study of all animals. She went beyond the science community to reach people all over the world to raise awareness for the physical threats and endangered environments for animals and people. Jane Goodall broke barriers for everyone, humans, animals, and nature alike. She shows us to this day that we need to help our Earth and everything living on it, because we are deforesting trees and the homes in which wildlife lives, killing endangered species, and we are polluting our oceans, air, and overall world. The barriers Jane Goodall broke brought and is still bringing the world closer together.